Hi everyone, in the last session we have seen multi-quadrant operation of separately excited DC motor by using a reversing switch and also with dual converter. This is another type of multi-quadrant operation of separately excited DC motor, that is by using the field current reversal. So here again single phase fully controlled converter, either three phase or single phase, is connected to the DC motor. This is DC motor armature. So here armature is connected to the rectifier output. The rectifier, corresponding armature rectifier firing angle is alpha A. And the output voltage of the rectifier or armature voltage is VA. The current is entering into the armature from the common cathode of the rectifier. So another one is, as this is separately excited DC motor, the field is connected through the dual converter here. Other two type of converters are using to fully control rectifier as a dual converter in the field circuit. So here again, by using the same three phase AC supply or single phase AC supply, fully control converter is connected, that is field converter 1. The corresponding firing angle is alpha F1, and the field converter 2, the corresponding firing angle is alpha F2, is connected in the field circuit, across the field circuit. Now, when this motor, let us assume that initially that is in the forward motoring mode. In the forward motoring mode, the armature fully controlled converter can give only positive current with either positive voltage or negative voltage. That depends on the alpha A. If alpha A varies from the 0 to 90 degrees, it will work like a rectifier, so that you will get the positive voltage with positive armature current. Hence, the motor is in forward motoring condition. With field converter 1, when field converter 1 is operating, again here also the current is coming out from the common cathode, so that your field current IF is conventional direction of the field current IF is in this way. So with this field current you are getting the speed is positive and current is positive, so speed torque characteristics are in the first quadrant. Again, if you increase the firing angle from 90 to 180 degrees, it will work like a inverter, hence it will enter into the fourth quadrant. First and fourth quadrant with the field current in one direction like this. So by allowing the field current in one direction, how we are allowing the field current in one direction? By turning on the field converter 1 with the armature fully controlled converter. And by allowing the field current in one direction, it will work in the quadrant 1 and quadrant 4. So quadrant 1, quadrant 4, this field current in one direction by turning on the alpha F1 or field converter 1. So how do you get the quadrant 1 operation? By varying the alpha between 0 to 90 degrees. How to get the quadrant 4? By varying the firing angle between 90 to 180 degrees. So in this way, by allowing the field current in one direction, by varying the firing angle of the armature converter, you can get the first and fourth quadrant. Again, by reversing the field converter current or by reversing the field current, how do you reverse the field current? We need to turn off this field converter 1 and we need to turn on the field converter 2. When you turn on the field converter 2, the current will flow in this direction. This is simply open circuit, and current will flow in the opposite direction to the conventional direction. So IF will be flowed in the opposite direction. So your IF is getting reversed. Hence, it will be operated in other, because your armature converter is working like a fully controlled converter, only field direction is getting reversed. With that field current in reverse direction, again it will be operated in third and second, or second and third. To operate in the second converter to get the positive voltage, right? Again here we need to provide the firing angle of the armature converter between 0 to 90 degrees to get into the third quadrant, that is both voltage and current negative, or speed and torque are negative, means it need to work with 90 to 180 degrees. So in this way we can get all four quadrant of operations. So if you want to go for wide range of speed operations, when the speed control is in wide range, then the field current is controlled. Generally here we are directly giving the field current. If you are controlling this field current itself by controlling the firing angle of the corresponding field converters, there is a possibility for wide range of speed control. We know that field control can give the wide range of speed control, right? So here we are not controlling the field current, simply we are giving field current by allowing one fixed field firing angle. Instead of that, if you are controlling this one, your field current will be controlled, hence you can get the wide range of speed of operation. So the procedure here, the speed reversal process is given here. So this is nothing but speed reversal process. Here the speed reversal process, initially the motor or drive is operating in the forward motoring mode. We need to advance the alpha A. We need to advance the alpha A means the armature rectifier firing angle set at the highest value to force that armature current to zero. We need to bring this armature current to zero. For that we need to increase this alpha A to the 180 degrees or highest value. Then the firing pulses are withdrawn. Now you remove the firing pulses because armature current is zero now. Next, allow a dead time of 10 milliseconds. Now you provide the dead time, some delay time of around 10 milliseconds. Now advance the alpha F1, because earlier when it is in motoring mode, this converter, your armature converter and field converter 1 is operating. We need to turn off both. We have turned off this armature converter. Now we need to turn off this field converter 1 also. To do that, again increase the firing pulses of the field converter 1 to the highest value. Okay. Now it operates as an inverter. Hence this field converter also becomes 0. Field converter also will be 0. IF becomes 0 and switch off the field converter 1. Again here also allow a dead time of 10 milliseconds to avoid the maloperation between the converter 1 to converter 2. We need to provide this dead time or delay time. Now start this field converter 2. We need to reverse this field current, right? For that we have turned off this armature converter and field converter. Now we are providing the firing pulses to this field converter 2 to allow the current in the reverse direction. Start the field converter 2, hence the back EMF is getting reversed. Now the back EMF is, or field current is allowing in the negative direction, means the back EMF will be generated in the reverse direction. Once this field converter 2 is turned on with negative field current, now you provide the firing pulses to the armature converter also. Hence it will work with the alpha A and alpha F2. Instead of alpha A with alpha F1, now the armature converter and field converter 2 are operated to get all these four quadrant of operation. Okay, so this is all about the field current reversal. Thank you all.